a couple of you do not have a company incorporated yet. Now, one thing generally is that when you are starting out a business, it's just at the idea stage. You are in a proof of concept stage. You're still figuring out whether this will ever gain traction, right? You are okay not incorporating a company at that point, because companies, once starting a company is a pain. It can take time, 1 to 3 months, maybe more at times. It costs you money. And once you start a company, there are regular compliances, and shutting down a company is not easy. So mind you, if you have a company and you don't shut it down, once you close the business but not shut down the company, you have to carry on the compliances like filings and all. Otherwise, there's significant fine and liability on you as a director. So you should never stop compliances. And that's why you should know when to start a company. But at the same time, the moment you are configuring that I want to carry on this business and take it to the next level, don't wait to incorporate a company. And the reason is, no investor is going to put in money into any entity other than a company. They will not invest in a partnership. They will not invest in a limited liability partnership. While technically they can, but a limited liability partnership is still not very appealing to investors. The only entity they will invest into is a company. And imagine you are in an investment round and it takes you 3 months to start the company, that delays your investment round by as much, right? Also, if you have already grown your business, and I've had clients who have, say, were running a sizable business as a partnership. Now to start a company at that point and to transfer the business from the partnership to the company can be very tax inefficient. There can be a significant expense in transferring business from a partnership or a proprietorship to a company. So that's why it's very important to time your company incorporation right. Now, under the new Companies Act, you can even start a one-person company. Earlier, you needed at least two people as directors and shareholders to start out a company. Now, even a single person can start a company. The challenge with that is, imagine tomorrow you're having an investor. Either you want a co-founder later on. You have to change the company itself, which is problematic. The second is, if you have an investor coming on board, typically, one, the investor now becomes the shareholder in the company, right? So you need, I mean, you can't live with a one person. Second is, investor will want a director also on the company. So a one person will not work at that stage. And that is why, you know, I would suggest that unless you are sure you are not creating an investable business, it is not a business in which you will raise funding and not a business in which you will add co-founders, you should not go for a one person company.